I've been asked to do many things in my life. Coach a basketball team, talk to kids, work, do tons of different things, but I can't think of a more special honor to be asked to come to speak to you this morning in this setting. To give honor to God first, my Lord and Savior, and to also recognize a very, very special person that God has brought in my life that has come along with me to give me some moral support. I had hoped that the group that I met when I came in was meant to give me that type of support, but I found out they were as nervous as I was. I realized they were really nervous when I saw their notes, and then on the note it said, "I must say you must be seen." And as you can see, they still had trouble with it. Give one blessing for a spouse as great as mine.
Scholarship Committee.
Seniors of St. Albans High School for a job well done, but let me say one other thing to you. I'd like to have you come to the project party we're going to give after graduation. We have a car to give away, a couple TV sets to give away, a little fishing equipment, a little bit of money you can use on your trip to wherever you're going to after graduation. We'd like to invite you to come there. C&O Motors has always been gracious enough to rent the institute place at the rehab center with the swimming and all the various things for you. And we need you to come and enjoy that party because we think it's going to be a great time. And I'm sure you'll have a good time there. But I'd like to give scholarships based on the people who work with Bingo. And the fact is that Lynn Grawl is taking care of getting this done. And you had to submit the application. The winners are as follows. Shelly Mooney, you'll come forward. Carla Meadows, Gary Rugel, and Jeff Conley. The next scholarship was also presented in memory of a lady who was an educator and lived in this community, I suppose, most of her life, and gave all of her resources, not only as a teacher, but otherwise in civic pride to the community. Mr. Charles Covert will present the Bernadine Best Scholarship.
Also add my congratulations to each member of the class of 1997, and I trust and hope that as you leave this school and this community, that you each find a large measure of happiness. Remember what you've got here, nurturing the love and hope that this community has provided. For the second year, I am honored to present the Bernadine Best Memorial Scholarship. Bernadine Best was one of my teachers. I feel very fortunate to have known her and loved her the best. Many of the faculty of this school, I'm sure, remember well Bernadine Best. Many of your parents remember well Bernadine Best. She was the epitome of an educator, of someone who loved her family, loved her community, dearly cared about each and every one of her students. As I did last year, I would challenge the winners of this scholarship to ask questions and learn a little bit about Bernadine Best. Because if you can be true to her character, her integrity, her gentleness, this will be an award well worth it. I'd like to take just a moment to introduce Bill Best. I think Bill is here. Bill is a brother of Bernadine Best. Bill, where are you? Stand and acknowledge you. Bill's kind of shy. And love for his sisters. This scholarship is three scholarships, each in the amount of $2,000, chosen on the basis of scholastic accomplishment, character, and need. 1997 winners are Alyssa Shamblin, Sarah Perdue, Thank you.
congratulations also to the class of 1997. I feel kind of old looking out at you guys. Congratulations. My name is Sandy Murphy, and I am vice chair of the Greater Kanawha Valley Foundation. The Greater Kanawha Valley Foundation is a not-for-profit community foundation located here in the Kanawha Valley. This year, we celebrate our 35th anniversary. What started out as a fund of $20,000 has now grown to a community foundation with assets of close to $65 million. One of the foundation's primary goals is to provide scholarships to deserving students planning to attend college. This year, the Greater Kanawha Valley Foundation received applications from 1,187 new applicants, 324 renewal applicants, for a total of 1,511 applicants. We awarded 129 new awards, 212 renewal awards, for a total of 341 scholarships. The average ACT of our new applicants and recipients was 24.5, high school grade point average was 4.75, and the average award was approximately $1,400 per scholarship. This year, the total amount awarded to deserving students by the Greater Kanawha Valley Foundation was approximately $489,000. This year, the Greater Kanawha Valley Foundation is proud to present two scholarships. The first scholarship is the John W. and Ruth E. Powell Scholarship. This scholarship was made possible by John W. and Ruth E. Powell, and it is awarded to deserving students who are residents of Kanawha County pursuing an undergraduate study at West Virginia State College. This year, we are proud to present this award to Jessica Daniels.
Thank you.
Memorial Scholarship. This scholarship is made possible by the Nicholas and Mary Agnes Trevilian Memorial Scholarship Fund, and it's awarded to deserving students showing financial need who are residents of the state of West Virginia and pursuing courses of study in the field of medicine or in pharmacy programs. This year, the Greater Kanawha Valley Foundation is proud to award this scholarship to Demisha McFarland.
Always with great pleasure and pride that I return each year to make this award in honor of my husband, Roger Switzer. Five of my six children graduated from St. Albans High School, and as Mr. Harrison said, I'm a former teacher for 7 years of Latin and English. On the occasion of Roger's retirement, forced retirement due to the cancer, a plaque was presented to him by the Charleston Housing Authority, which he directed for 19 years. And the plaque said, "This man touched lives and stirred dreams. He painted a vision of the possible, rolled up his sleeves, and built. and call the community to caring. Roger did that not only in Charleston, but also in the community of St. Albans, where he lived for 23 years. Whether it be as a member of the library board helping to sponsor the St. Albans Community Fair, or as a member of the Western Little League, Senior League, whatever, PTA of the local schools, athletic boosters, he called the community to care, and he rolled up his sleeves and built. It is with great pleasure, then, that I present the Roger Switzer Memorial Scholarship to Amy Paul.
As my mother said, it's a great pleasure that we come back here today. This is the second time that we've given the Amory Switzer Memorial Scholar Athlete Award. It is presented in recognition of outstanding merit and accomplishment of both a student and an athlete. My sister was an extraordinary person, both as a student and an athlete. She was named KBC Co-Player of the Year and played on two state final basketball teams, ones where they won. She went on to attend Concord College and received a degree in accounting and became a CPA before she died January 27, 1996. This year's award is presented to Robin Foster.
Thank you.
celebration to the commander who signed the certificate. Commander of our post is Janet E. Mann. She said she wasn't any relation, so we'll approve the citation. The young man winning the American Legion School Award for 1997, John Scott Sarek.
Also a civic group within our community, the St. Albans Music Appreciation Club is represented this morning by Mrs. Becky Bailey.
The Music Appreciation Club of St. Albans is honored to present two awards this morning, one for outstanding vocalist and one for outstanding instrumentalist. The recipients of these awards are chosen by Mr. White and Mr. Gray. The Outstanding Vocalist 1997 is Tiffany Lawrence. The Outstanding Instrumentalist for 1997 is Teresa Young.
Representing the University of West Virginia in a scholars program is Ms. Dee Hill. Has been enhanced this year. For students who excel in academics
requirements of a 3.5 GPA and a 26th composite on her ACT. A scholarship of $1,000 per year for 4 years has been awarded. Please join me in honoring the Mountaineer Scholars, recipients from St. Albans High, Lynn Bird, Heather Green, Carissa Lahoga, David Lukowski, and last but not least, Vance McCracken.
Presenting the Junior Order of the United American Mechanics is Mr. Miller.
Maybe I should say, let's go Red Dragon. Here. letter that congratulates a lady who has been outstanding in her class. That lady, Miss Jennifer McLaughlin.
So we'll speak up. Thank you. Okay. From the Charleston newspapers, presenting both an award from the Charleston newspapers and from the flip side is Mr. Stu Shirk. Mr. Shirk.
Good morning. Congratulations. This is a big day. I'd like to say a few years ago, but it's been several. And this is my first opportunity to be here and present these awards. Bringing back fond memories. I am Stu Shirk, and I am circulation manager of the South Zone for Charleston newspapers. St. Albans and the surrounding area are in my jurisdiction. Today, I am proud to represent Charleston newspapers in presenting three of St. Albans High School's best and brightest with their 97 scholarship awards. Two of these young people represent the Charleston Daily Mail, and one represents the Charleston Gazette. They have all three on occasion been chosen as district representatives for other newspaper-related programs because we believe that they are the best. I would like to thank all these carriers for the dedication they have shown in the job they have done for Charleston newspapers and for the service that they have given their many happy customers over the years. First, for the Daily Mail, Misha McFarland has been awarded the Daily Mail's top scholarship of $1,000. $1,500 in scholarship. Also for the Daily Mail, Jessica Daniels has been awarded a $500 scholarship for 97, which brings the total Jessica has earned through her years as a carrier to $1,500. And for the Charleston Gazette, I would like to present Jason Leach with a scholarship in the amount of $1,000. Jason's career total scholarship is $3,000.
From the Walmart Corporation, I'm delighted to invite to the podium at this time Ms. Tammy Canterbury.
Good morning. Congratulations. On behalf of the Sam Walt Community Leadership Foundation and the Walmart Store 2036 in South Charleston, I'm proud to present a